of us. We're talking about extreme northwestern corner of Missouri. Atchison, Nottoway County, you've now been downgraded to a severe thunderstorm warning, but it is still this little hook that is still right along Iowa state line between Atchison County, Missouri, and the southern portion of Iowa. And as you see here, it's really very little of it still left on the Missouri side of state line. But it has been to the north of Tarkio. There had been a confirmed touchdown from law enforcement. It's still tracking to the east at 20. Some of these cities that we mentioned will be on the Iowa side more so than on the Missouri side. But nonetheless, you still see from College Springs all the way to Elmo, farther out east on this particular warning that we've tracked for you. Still looks like you're going to be under the gun for this potential tornado. Has had a confirmed touchdown earlier north of Tarkio. That is the one and only one that seems to be out for that region. Farther east, again, Nottoway County, just to the east of that, the sirens were going off. We've got reports coming into the First Alert Weather Center that they are no longer sounding. This is now to the north of Maryville, and you can see in the animation mode, this one is continuing to move primarily east toward the rural portions of Nottoway County. Eventually, I want to give the heads up to Worth County. You're probably going to get this thunderstorm, but right now, hail seems to be the number one thing we have to worry about, more so than the tornado threat. But nonetheless, there's spotters out there. We're getting reports here into the First Alert Weather Center. We're going to continue to monitor that as well. And remember, Aaron was also looking at this little band that was down over Riley County and just to the west of that. This one is starting to diminish, so it still looks like now the biggest show or the best chances for severe weather will remain to the north of us. There you see the tornado warnings, this time on the Iowa side of state line, still under the watch until 2 in the morning, but I bet you probably some of these counties will be allowed to expire before we get to that 2 o'clock deadline. And on live First Alert Doppler radar, still showing you that most of it is on the Iowa side more so than down here on the Missouri side of things. City View camera has it at 83. 1.27 inches of rain, something we don't want to see in the Missouri Basin. Still quite saturated with that humidity standing at 70%. So it's going to be steamy. Does not look like it's going to be a repeat performance of what we had last night. However, we are seeing more redevelopment, more of a concentrated line of thunderstorms that may try to arc down toward us. So between now and 4 in the morning, especially north of 36 Highway, that's where the severe thunderstorm threat will lie, especially as these warnings are continuing to light up primarily north and west of Maryville at this point in time. Want to widen it out and show you that as you look farther to the west, here are some of the other showers and thunderstorms that are popping up in a line. So it looks like more active weather out over Nebraska, where they still have some severe thunderstorm warnings and even a few tornado warnings too. Back here, what we are looking at least in the short term, 92 degrees here in Kansas City, going to be a hot and humid day tomorrow. Any showers and thunderstorms between midnight, ending by the morning commute, warming up and getting sticky, feeling like close to 100 by 6 p.m. And the pops start to go down, with the probabilities being over the morning as opposed to the afternoon hours. But we also have another characteristic we have to worry about with these thunderstorms. I'm talking severe weather. Team coverage now with meteorologist Aaron Little.
And Bryan, you can see within our weather center, our team continuing to track the very latest. And this same system that's been plaguing us since Friday is going to continue to give us that threat for severe weather once again for your Monday. Let me show you the heart of Kansas City from Smithville through Overland Park, down through Lee Summit and Blue Springs, all included. And the risk for severe weather for your Monday. And you can see it extends for the bulk of our viewing area. All of the orange under the risk for severe weather, but where we will see the greatest risk for that tornadic activity, that will be over portions of Nebraska and Iowa. But that is the same similar setup to what we are seeing today. So we will be keeping a very close eye on the radar and the skies once again for tomorrow as well. Back over to you.
Thank you so much there. So this is the live picture of, once again, from Martin Augustine's vantage point up toward Holt County on the Missouri side, a light show for sure. And that's part of the reason why we have those thunderstorms that are producing the tornado warnings out between Iowa and Missouri over the extreme northwestern corner of Missouri. This is going to be future scans take on things, as it looks like we do have those thunderstorms that are popping up. Some that could be on the heavy to severe side, coming once again, as Aaron mentioned, toward the second half of your day. Here's your 7-day forecast. 92 turns into 84 on Tuesday, with leftovers primarily in the morning. 79 on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And she hinted at this last night that it was going to be much cooler, much more comfortable for the latter half of the work week before another chance of thunderstorms moves through. On Saturday, a high temperature then of 83 degrees. Sunday's high temperature, 87. So right now, still monitoring that situation. Tornado warning staying in effect for about another 15, 20 minutes or so. That was north of Tarkio, a confirmed touchdown. Still monitoring. Don't know if it's still on the ground. We're still gathering information right now.